your news?
Well, what news do I have?
Well, I'm trying to think, really. Gosh, I always have so many things to talk about. I'm starting an oil painting course tomorrow morning. How about that?
That's exciting.
And I'd never done that before. I've run circuses all my life, and I was an acrobat, and I play lots of instruments, and I can balance a fish and a pair of knickers on my nose.
Amazing.
Yes.
You haven't got them with you, have you?
No, I don't.
But how long were you in the circus world for?
All my life. All my life. I'm semi. We sold the last circus 7 years ago, so I'm now semi-retired. You see, hence it was either taking up painting or buying a motorbike, but I don't like motorbikes. I ride bicycles.
There's been a lot of criticism recently over the years, I guess, working with animals, all the rest of it. How do you see it from working within?
My own personal feeling is I like to see domestic animals, which brings me to Henry. Henry is soon going to be 10, but he was the world's only mind-reading dog. And he worked with me for 7 years in the circus. He was the world's only mind-reading dog, and he could penetrate people's innermost darkest corners and their thoughts.
How did he convey what he was reading?
Well, what we used to do, now you've got me on the subject, we used to look around the audience, and I'd pick somebody out, and I'd say, stand up. And I'd get them to empty their minds completely, see? Henry would come on, and I would ask them to think of a number, and Henry would tell me the number that they were thinking of. they'd have to think of an odd number, you see? Any odd number in the world, between 1 and 4. And then what Henry would do, he would do a couple of roly-polies and come up to me and lick me 3 times. And there you are.